today I'm gonna cast games about the Battle Cup for Southern Asia, tier 6. The Dire is Nux and Octonan, and for the Radiant, which is the Dark Knight. Okay, the first pick for the Noctanan is Augur Magi, while for the Dark Knight is Slada and Invoker. Oh, they're gonna go for an early gank. For the Dryad, probably they're gonna go for most likely Augur Magi, probably an Elfling as well. Axe or Underlord, yes, probably they're gonna go for a ganking Elfling, so it's gonna be Underlord Elfling while Augur Magi on the 4th or the 5th position. We'll see what's that pick. Well, for the Dark Knight, they're gonna ban probably maybe like a carry like Luna, yes, for example Weaver, TA. Well, on the Radiant, on the what we call Noctanan, they want to ban something that's more going for the ganking hero as well. Probably Void, they're gonna ban, probably Vengeful Spirit as well. Something that we will see how the Dark Knight is gonna pick first. Slark for ganking, so mostly they're gonna stop the Dark Knight. So basically, the Radiant side is gonna play a little bit more aggressive on the early game with a Draw Ranger, Invoker pushing the lane while Slada ganking and Invoker Sunstrike, so it's gonna be Quas Axel Sunstrike most likely, and Juggernaut and Underlord. They're gonna play on the Dire, they're gonna play more aggressive ganking, like, and easily to rotate with Augur Magi and Underlord. Juggernaut's going for Yasha build. The Radiant, they probably need more like a Vengeful Spirit, most likely. Or a Spirit, Vengeful Spirit. I have watched some of the game from the Dark Knight. Their Invoker is very good player, which is Mech Keba, a mid player for them. And the Chill, which is their carry, and Old Man Lomax is their offlane, and the another two is like, one is Zero Lucian, this one is Zero Lucian, which is a support, so they're gonna play Disruptor support, 5th position, and also at 4th position for the Earth Spirit. My team so good is playing Earth Spirit most likely, if they're gonna pick that. They ban TA because they don't want more base damage. Burst damage with Augur Magi and Koto on the Dire side for the safe push, safe defense against pushing, so basically anti-push. Koto has the 5th position and 4th position, Augur Magi probably roaming Augur. An Omni Knight banned. Okay, for the end up, I'm not sure who's the carriers. Probably is Albacurus. Oh, they're gonna go for all of the Aurora for another ganking hero. The Dark Knight probably gonna go for a Vengeful Spirit or Earth Spirit, most likely, to gank all of the Aurora with the Silence as well as the Stun. Gonna be like a chain stun hero, so just to stop them from anything. I'll probably like anti push hero as well, anti gank hero. Earthshaker could work, but it's not really an optimum. But most likely, they're gonna pick a spirit here.
Yeah, okay.
Oh, and so basically start off support and adds offlane, and Disruptor gonna play as a 5th position and Slada on the 4th position, and Draw Ranger they're gonna go bottom, carry as a invoke a mid. Now it's the picking phase for the heroes. They're probably going for an early smoke with Flatline Disruptor to kill the Outlivora or probably the offlane. With a smoke gank. Invoker gonna Sunstrike. With a chain stun from Slada. And that's, I don't know if they gonna go gank at top against Juggernaut. So here games begin. We will see how the game goes. I'm not quite good with using the T, so we'll see how it goes. Okay, so here's the Invoker Mech Keba on the Radiant, and my team so good on the fifth position. Disruptor, while Slada's a Zerolution as Slada, together with X Old Man Lemox on offlane. He's buying quick Iron Talent for that so that he can go to jungle anytime soon. That's Hydro item build. Just gonna go for a safe lane carry on shield. And AMD on your offlane just properly. Then scout around the disruptor. He saw the ward here over here. Vile by couriers on the mid lane. Gonna take the rune bottom for the bounty board. For the Dire Bounty, while Juggernaut gonna take the top, but sorry, it's pretty hard to control. Juggernaut again. Okay, the Invoker gonna go against the Outworld Devourer. Jungle immediately, but Slider is gonna die if he's not going back. He's just gonna play safe right now because he cannot die. He's gonna play as an off lane support. Just taking the level and letting X getting a real farm bottom. Dro is doing quite fine. Net worth currently is on the Dire side, winning. Juggernaut on the first place, while Invoker on the second. While they get a first blood, Dro get a third blood, and the Disruptor get a first blood. The Underlord is a bit over commit, going outside the tower. Need to play a bit more safe. Not gonna die. Invoker going against OD, he's doing quite fine with the early Exort build and Wet. The recent change of the patch, they increase the mana for electricity, so it's gonna be a bit harder for Invoker to sustain the lane because he's gonna lose a lot of mana every time he uses electricity, but at the same time it's also easier for him to farm with electricity. So that's one of the main reasons why the current patch why Invoker playing early Exort Rex and getting quads on the fourth level. First, I'm gonna silver camp. I'm gonna go against Polar Bear on the Kotal. It's running away, Flutter. Just gonna play a bit more safe. Just gonna go for a quick magic wand. Juggernaut is sitting on the first rank of the net worth right now, currently with 1.6k gold. Slada is gonna hit a little bit. Kotal just need to be a bit more safe. If you're not, it's gonna die with a spin from the Juggernaut. The Disruptor's going against Outward Devourer, just gonna keep hitting Outward Devourer. Cannot kill the Disruptor, but the draw is coming to gank as well. Then, yeah, it's too many, it's too tanky. Oh, the Sunstripe! Oh, nice Sunstripe from Matt Kerba. Matt Kerba on the Evoke on the first, on the Nethworth right now. Going against Outward Devourer. It's not doing quite well because of the damage. I mean, like, Matt Kerba have higher damage than the Ibai Kurius. Augur is gonna put some wards on down on top. Axe is rotating top, getting some EXP as well, or be helping top lane. He already has his tranquil boot. It's just gonna stay on the lane. Simply, all Augur is coming to help the top lane. Oh, the calls from all Lomax, all men Lomax. The spins from Squee. It's gonna be a find. And the axe is that. Sunstrike? Oh, that Sunstrike missed. Jungling. It's gonna go for Max Axe Sword and getting Gwex after that. And probably only one or two levels on the boss. You see, already has Miss Midas on the 5 minutes into the game. Chill is doing pretty bad on the safe lane right now. It's pretty hard to farm against Outward Devourer because of the third skill, you get more damage every single creep deck. Just free farming while their spots is ganking. Meat's nearly died. Mech Kevlar going for an soon. Is tipping to help ganking the Outward Devourer. The Dire side doesn't have any wards, so they're probably gonna get their kill. Yes, they're chasing the Outward Devourer and the stunt from Slada. Oh, in the meantime, the Dire managed to get the kills on the Invoker. Old Man Lomax tried to help, but didn't manage to help him. And the Dire managed to get a kill on Outward Devourer. The courier, low HP. Currently on the top frag of the net worth is Juggernaut. Going for a Facebook and probably Yasha. Since the current of the nerf for the price, the Helm of Dominator. So most Juggernaut. go for Flamingo Manager, because that even though it's still good to buy the Hunt. The call from S and the Fun Strike from Invoker and the the Calling Blade. Calling Blade, yes. My team so good, try to help. Oh, he called like the polar bear. Probably gonna die here, probably gonna die. One more, last hit. Oh, he get the kills. In the bottom lane, Structor and Aug going against Augur and Outworld Devourer. Probably doing quite fine by his own, unless it's over going too much outside his own tower. Outworld Devourer trying to get a bounty rune, but the bounty rune is gone. So he's gonna go back, I think. No, he's going back to mid. My team's a good trying to walking around, finding someone. Probably just joking around the coastal. My team's only is probably much dead if it's, yeah, he doesn't have TP, he's dead. Bottom lane. Drew going Gugant, already Bora is trying to slowly killing him. Juggernaut and Kotal is trying to gank chop. The stunt from Flutter, the call from Old Man Lomax, and yes, probably gonna die because of this. What we call Battle Hunger? Oh no, only first level of Battle Hunger. Oliver Dory in the meantime died to Grow Ranger because of the slows. The Calling Blade and the Juggernaut spins around trying to kill Old Man Lomax, but he changed his target to kill the little Flutter. Old Man Lomax going again. You need to be careful. If not, yes, he's gonna die. The Calling. No Calling Blade, nothing. Just gonna die immediately. But the bottom lane is Drew and Disruptor is going to push the bottom lane. We will see the item choice for the Underlord. Right now he's going for what we call Arcane Boots and as well as Proven Shield for safety measures against Drow Ranger. And Olave is probably going for a quick, probably 4 stuff to Aggro Perception. And Augur Magi is just gonna have no money. Juggernaut going for Yasha. And Odin managed to buy Midas to go for the late game. Invoker also have his own Midas going for an Eel Scepter next for his first item. Probably going to set up for his Sunstrike and to turn into the Meteor Blast. Instructor already have his own Arcane. He's gonna stay bottom. Miracris managed to spot him. Is trying to get some farm while buying some sentries to get his own Ring Dagger. Sorry that my camera shakes off quite a bit because I'm still not used to this. This is my first time casting right now. Okay, we're just gonna go to the jungle and probably get the bounty rune as well. Farming a little bit. Drow is probably gonna go into mid and stay farm. The Dire is gonna push bottom. Put some waterfall to secure the tower. Disruptor 4 will be gonna GP soon. Or maybe trying to deny the tower in the meantime. While the draw and the slider is trying to help bottom. And here comes the call into the Sunstrike. And here the slider spawning and stun to make you get one. All the people also die. And the Juggernaut try to kill Zero Lucian. Call misses and the stuns manage to run away. And also Juggernaut, so it's that spawns that for the Dai. So currently on the highest net worth is Invoker on 6.5k. They're trying to do what as well to save, to secure the bottom tower. And here comes the Disruptor and all the X call. Sada's sons. Drill, killing, trying to kill the Overdevourer and its code draw also died. They are overcommitted, which is pretty bad for the Radiant side. However, they managed to run the structure, managed to run. Only one survived, and no person died on the die. The city, so how much you build change. Currently, let's see as well the graph difference. You see the change between after the all call the tower bottom. They managed to get a tower though, which is pretty good. So this is net worth space created for the invoker currently. So farming pretty well, going for Agrim Scepter next after his Wood of Travel. Slada is still getting his Wing Dagger, it's pretty hard for him to farm. Drow on the main chime is trying to gank, which Slada probably, however, I don't think they will get anything out of this. They're all rotating, the Radiant side all rotating together, trying to gank the Juggernaut. They got stunned, oh the miss, stunned. With the call, managed to get a cooling blade as well, which is good. They managed to kill the Juggernaut, the top. Frag on the Dire side, right now they're gonna push the first tower on the top side. While in the meantime, our Devourer is just gonna push together with Underlord and Ogre Magi to push middle. So they're gonna trade towers. However, the Drow is gonna push very, very quickly though. Sorry, Divinage. Before we're gonna defend middle as well. Drow is already. Limbs back to X call. There's no damage though. I don't think they're gonna get any of this. Drow is coming in and the Sunstrike misses. Slada is trying to stun, but he already got his Blink Dagger. He will probably gonna gank with the Blink Dagger soon. Drow is calling bait on the Iron Devourer. Well, X is gonna die because of the damage. And now Drow is running away from our Devourer and the slows, the ignite from Ogre Magi.
Mega kill! Double kill!
However, Invoker is still free farming. He's trying to get his levels and farm. Just doing Invoker things until he managed to get online. Stuns from Slada into the Sunstrike and is dead. Unlord. Oh, ouch. That hurts a lot. It's currently on third fragger. Lowest. It's pretty sad for him. Didn't manage to get anything. Bowser. An augmented I'm probably gonna go for. Probably going for Mecha. No problem. Destructor is gonna go for. Invisible. Scissor. Help the team. Drow is straight gonna go to Roshan. With Slada. The amplify damage. With Slada. The Colossus haste. While Axe is jungling, just preparing for the gank if they manage to. It's probably the Roshan gonna go down easily for the Radiant fight. We'll see on the Dire side. Analog is going for Mecha, okay. So he's gonna play a bit more safe for his own team, and probably. Juggernaut already has his own Mancha. Our Devourer probably going for Hurricane Pike and maybe straight to BKB after he finishes on Hurricane Pike. To gank with smoke, probably pushing top as well. Who bought the Helm of Dominator? Probably the Drow Ranger. Oh. Trying to get scouting. There's Crush. Probably into call. Everything is dead. Three dead on the Dire side. GG call. By the Radiant. No. The Juggernaut's trying to kill him, he will die as well. The network change. So right now it's 7.5k for the Raiden. Probably 8,000. The Conqueror. Trying to get some X call into the Sunstrike and Calling Blade. I thought of Slada Crush. The Glimpse. For the Kotal, trying to kill Alivora, trying to salvage some of the stuff without his ultimate, probably gonna die as well. Top is down. Invoker's gonna TP board them and quick farming. Axe going for Vanguard and probably going for Blade Mail next. They bought it to Korea. The trash talking. And we're not tier 6, we cannot run from trash talking. My team's so good, trying to gank someone in the mid. Oh, Juggernaut just used his ultimate on Destructor. That's a bit obvious, probably a bit unlucky as well. Even though they already have the what to see? The rune. Illusion rune. Uncle Magi taking the bounty rune. Juggernaut is getting harder. It's harder for the Dire side to defend against the Radiant side. Even the Destructor is on 5k, is higher level against the offlane underlord. Mm-hmm. play safe, pushing the shrine first. Flutter, playing around, searching for a vision ward. Glimmer kit done by Disruptor. He's going for Agony Capture next. Flutter is trying to find some, which is Blink Dagger into Citrine Crush. He's going in, yeah. Goes with Citrine Crush, but there's no backup for him. Roranger with double damage is gonna push very very quickly with Alpha Citri as well. Old Man ready to go in with his call into Sunstrike and then the Gust from the Roranger. Meteor Blast and the Disruptor Ultimate. The Aegis has been gone. The Dire trying so hardly to defend against the Radiant. They managed to defend for some time. And here goes Flutter again, trying to get the Juggernaut Ultimate as well. Tornado into... This game is pretty much done. OD buyback. Probably Juggernaut will buy back as well. They're trying so hard to defend. However, it's pretty bleak. Dust. Invoker is getting ready. And go Tornado again into EMP. And then Tornado. Pretty much. No mana right now. My team's so good. Low in mana. Oh, ouch. It's hurt. I will buy two couriers. The names. It should support. Trash talking. You cannot run from trash talk. It's everywhere. And it's going for pipe first. Spawning going for Shivas as well. Or probably Crimson Guard for his next item choice. So going for eels and then for stuff. Probably going for eels against the Juggernaut Omni Slash. But the Alba Devourer still is going for BKB, but it's too late. Tornado into Wax, EMP, and then Meteor Blast into the Deafening. Sunstrike is coming, we missed the Sunstrike. Slada is dead. Oh. Are we seeing comeback for Dire currently? We will see the net worth change. It's going down uphill, downhill a little bit. Tornado into EMP. Probably trying to zone out them a bit with the mana burnt. Sunstrike. Portal is tipping out. Invoker just trying to delay them as well. And Owl Devourers managed to get away. Every single one of them. Saves. Koto is pretty good against defense against crit. So they have a chance to win this game. Invoker is going for his next item. the old train called Mekeba. Going for age Roshan right now, so Drew is gonna take the ages, putting down his own stupid into the stash. The backpack, what we call the backpack, not the stash. Drew is just pushing around the lanes. Crush missed. Over Devorah running away from trying to save the base, but it's pretty hard. The GG has been called by the Radiant. Roll Ranger. The fountain, Laguna on the side, and the game is done. Okay, thanks for watching, guys, and the Dark Knight victory.